you heard of the blind harper, how he lived in Lochmaven town, how he went down to fair England to steal King Henry's wanton brown. First he went unto his wife with all the haste that go could he. This work, he said, it'll never go well without the help of our good grey mare. Says she, take good grey mare, she'll run o'er hills both low and high. Go take the halter in your hose and leave a foal at home with me. So he's up to England gone, even as fast as go could he. When he got to Carlisle gates, who should be there but King Henry? Come in, you blind harper, and of your music let me hear. But up and says the blind harper, I'd rather have a stable for my mare. King, he looks over his left shoulder, and he says unto his stable groom, go take the poor blind harper's mare and put her beside me wanton brown. Then he's harped and then he sang till he played a morse sound asleep, and quietly he took off his shoes and down the stairs he did creep. And straight to the stable door he goes with a tread as light could be. And when he opened and went in there, he found 30 steeds and three. And he took a halter from his hose, and from his purpose he did not fail. He slipped it over the wanton's nose, and he's tied it to the grey mare's tail. And he let him loose at the castle gate, and the mare didn't fail to find her way. Back to her own cold fold 3 long hours before the day. Behold, the wanton brown was gone, and so was the poor blind harper's mare. And oh, and alas, says the blind harper, however, alas, that I come here. In Scotland I've got me a little cold foal, and in England they've stolen me good grey mare. Hold your tongue, says King Henry, and all your mournings let them be. For you shall get a far better mare, and well paid shall your cold foal be. And again he harped, and again he sang, sweet was the music he let them hear. He was paid for a foal that he never had lost, 3 times over for the good grey mare.